Welcome back to the show. Thousands of new jobs, billions in extra funding for the regions, and even the prospect of new coal-fired power stations. These are the enormous, juicy carrots being dangled in front of the Nationals to reach agreement over zero emissions, but still, there's no deal. For more, we're joined by Queensland National Senator Matt Canavan, who's in Canberra, and in Sydney, the editor-in-chief of Stella and Body and Soul magazine, Sarah Lamarquand. Nice to see you, ladies and gentlemen. Matt. Good start. Matty, have you seen the plan yet, or are you just saying no because you're not a yes man?
Well, number one, we haven't seen enough detail. People are very angry with the Nationals Party down here in Canberra, but when people are angry with us down here, I know we're doing our job for people back home. And we haven't seen enough to assure us that jobs in regional Australia will be protected, our future will be protected, and that's of course why when you get a proposal that you don't like, of course you go back and say, well, you've got to up the price.
So what's the price?
Well, that's what we're discussing with our Liberal colleagues. I'd love to see a coal-fired power station built in this country. We should build the high-efficiency, low-emission, clean coal fired power stations that are being built all around the world. This is not inconsistent with net zero. Coal is not inconsistent with net zero because China has signed up to net zero. They're building 95 coal-fired power stations. Korea has signed up to net zero. They're building 5 coal-fired power stations. And Japan have signed up to net zero. They're building 7 coal-fired power stations. So if it's good enough for those countries to sign up to net zero while still providing reliable power for their people, it should be good enough for Australia as well.
The Prime Minister doesn't care what you think, does he? I mean, he's just pressing ahead regardless. He doesn't even need you.
Well, let's see what happens, Carl. Let's see what happens. The Nationals Party is a small little group, but we're a determined one. And we will just keep fighting.
OK. Sarah, News Limited has suddenly woken up as well, and it's all happening. Do you have a message from Matt Canavan and his carbon caravan?
Well, look, my message would actually be, if you own a TV station, when Matt says, we'll see what happens, I want to see what happens. Don't you think the next reality TV hit is inside the coalition party room? I mean, what is really being said here? Look, I think when Matt talks about you're probably doing the right job if you're in his position, if everyone's a bit angry in Canberra at you, I think there's a lot of merit to that. But I think where the Nats need to be careful here, Matt, if you want some free advice from me, is that we've seen a lot of rhetoric, but that's quite polarising and divisive, and saying that people in urban Australia, people in cities, don't have to pay a price, that it's very easy for people in cities to be committing to net zero. I don't really think that's true. That's why it's been such a polarising issue, what action we're going to take on climate change. Everyone's affected by it, but everyone's got a responsibility. So I'm going to grab the popcorn and see how this plays out.
I think everyone's just made up their own. Go on.
Well, look, I agree with Sarah on that. The biggest mining town in Australia is Brisbane. Over 100,000 people work in the mining industry in Brisbane. Perth is a massive mining town too. These jobs are all around the country. They're not just in the bush, and they will be affected if we get this wrong.
OK, so Matt, basically what you're saying is this morning, what it's going to take is, as a close mate of mine reckons, there's nothing more spiritual than cash if you're in doubt about anything. Just to, realign your strong values and everything. About $20 billion, a new coal-fired power station, that about do the trick?
Carl, it's not... The money is what attracts people, obviously, as you say, but that's not what this is about, because this is about the next generation for us. And the problem here is if there was cash on the table, money doesn't last.
You're saying this morning, show me the money.
Over time.
You're saying, show me the money.
No,
that's what you're saying.
Not. Carl, that is not what has been dominating discussions. What is most important to the Nationals Party is protecting these jobs and industries, because that is the future of our regions, of our towns, our communities. Mm.
Okay, let's move on. A couple of quick ones. Novak Djokovic. Let's catch up with what he's been up to during the pandemic. It's slope mad at the Christmas party in Canberra, shirt off, just going absolutely.
There are some photos of that around, Carl.
So he's a tennis great.
Me and George Christensen, actually.
No one needs to see that. Oh my goodness! Did you throw Clive Palmer in the mix as well, and you got quite the threesome?
He wasn't there that year.
That year, he can't come to Australia unvaccinated, despite being the best in the world, maybe the best ever. Can he, Matt?
I think he can. I think he should, because he's had COVID. I mean, this is where we're not following the science here. All of the studies... you can get it again if you're vaccinated. All of the studies show that natural immunity from getting COVID is roughly about 27 more times effective than the vaccine of preventing infection. We've seen that in a major study of 700,000 people in Israel just recently. And obviously, we should require Novak Djokovic to prove he has antibodies then, which you can do a test for.
I don't know that's
true,
Matt.
But let's follow the science here. If you've had COVID, you've probably got immunity.
Read
the science.
Anyway, I'm not going to get into the science.
Absolutely the fact.
I'm not going to get into the science. Sarah, no jab, no play, no exemptions, no exceptions?
Absolutely. I mean, this is nonsense. What's all this mumbo-jumbo? I mean, there's one rule. You get double-vaxxed, you're allowed into Melbourne. If you're not going to abide by that, then stay home, stay in your nightclub, keep your shirt off,
whatever. We should change the rules.
Don't do it in Australia.
Those rules are wrong.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with the rules. And I just think one thing that is really sticking in the core of the average Australian is this sort of two rules. If there's exemptions, if you're rich, if you're a well-known tennis player, forget about it.
All right,
I'm not saying it should be a rule for Novak. It should be a rule for everybody. If you've had COVID, and you've got natural immunity, you're better protected than having the vaccine.
Okay, so I can just imagine you, Matt Canavan, around the Australian Open, shirt off, dancing with Novak, just lighting up, building shapes on the floor, showing us what you got.
I've been double jabbed, so let's bring it on.
I reckon he'd be a good guy to go out with on the in Melbourne. That would be a good night out, I reckon.
There is actually no doubt about that.
Absolutely. If he just get double vaxxed, he could be here for it.
Thank you, guys.